best practices, and they brought this book called PMBOK, no, Project Management Body of Knowledge, the guide which PMI published towards this PMP is PMBOK, which you'll be knowing that about that later. For the timing, just remember that the book what is published by PMI is called PMBOK. If anyone is aware, that's fine. Yeah, one more thing which I want to set the expectations in this training is there may be different individual differences, no, among the participants. Some people, they might have already attended PMP earlier. Some people, they're well aware about the terminologies in PMP, what they use, or the topics what I will be discussing. There may be some people who doesn't know anything about PMP. So my target is are the people who doesn't know anything about PMP, and I'll be teaching the basics. Sometimes I'll be teaching, spending more time teaching the basics part. So please bear with me. People who already know the concept well, they may be feeling bored, but still, for the benefit of your friends who are the fellow participants, please bear with me. Though you know the concept, please bear with me, and you cooperate, right? And now, if you attend this course, you'll be knowing the best practices which are followed across the globe in different projects in different areas, and it increases the success rate of your project if you follow the best practices. PMP talks about the best practices when you are doing a project, right? When you are doing a project, how should you initiate a project? How should you plan your project? What are the best practices in that? How do you monitor and control the project? How do you execute the project? What are the best practices when you are closing the project? Even when you are closing the project, there are some practices, there are certain activities which you have to follow. What are these? That's what the PMP talks about. So when you follow the best practices, obviously the success rate of the project will be more, because you'll be more organized. And remember, all these best practices are tried and tested. They're all tried elsewhere. They were tested and they were producing results. It will definitely increase the success rate of your project. Currently, the world project success rate is 27%. It means only 27% of the projects across the globe are successful. Rest are all failures. Rest all are failures. Okay. So in order to increase the success rate, PMI has brought this PMP. Okay. And if you follow these best practices which are preached in this PMP session, better resource utilization can be achieved. When I say better resource utilization, less number of resources you can do the project. For example, earlier you are using 10 people to do a project. Now with 6 people you can do the same project. And in IT or anywhere, people are money. So your project will become cost effective if you use less number of resources. And if you start using those terminologies and the best practices, it changes how others look at your abilities. Your manager will start respecting you. Your peers will start respecting you. Your colleagues will come to you for advice. Your customer, when he talks something, you will understand, oh, what language he is talking. Because PMP, this particular course, will ensure a common language, whoever attends the course. When we say common language, everyone will use the same terminology. For example, if your customer uses a word called critical path, you will be knowing what is critical path, because across the projects, everyone knows what the critical path is. So the common language which are used in projects, you'll be knowing, and people will start respecting you. Maybe your manager may be shocked also. No, what happened to this guy suddenly? He's starting some terminology out of his head, so it will be a shocker for him also. So, and to keep your job, to get promoted, or to get a new job, or hike in current salary. Okay, so these are the various benefits you get when you are doing PMP. Okay, these are the topics which I have covered on Friday. I am doing a quick recap. So the people who attended on Friday, please bear with me, because there are many participants who are new and who have started only today. So I am again doing a recap of the session. And about PMP and PMI certification, PMP stands for Project Management Professional. PMI is Project Management Institute. PMI is the body, non-profit organization, who started this course, Project Management Professional, in 1969. You must be wondering, in 1969, we don't have IT, what these guys are doing. Actually, this was not started for the sake of IT. This was started for sake of project management. Projects are done in all the industries. Especially this was started to help other industries that time which were existing and even now which are existing, like construction industry, research and development industry. So they started for their sake. And now they changed the course, all these PMBOK 4, PMBOK 5s or whatever, like the new versions. They have become more compatible to IT also. So they started adding more and more aspects which are more related to IT. And PMI is the body which manages and monitors the PMP certification. And PMP is one of the most respected certifications in the world. Not only in project management area, in the world. Okay. And if you get PMP certified, it is valid for 3 years. It doesn't mean that on fourth year, again, you have to retake the examination. It's not that case. You have to renew it again. You have to renew it again. For renewing, you need two things as usual. One is money. There is some renewal amount which you have to pay. And some 60 PDUs we call, professional development units. 60 hours, in these 3 hours, in this 3 years, you have to gain some knowledge, do something related to project management, and for every hour, you'll get one PDU. So 60 hours, it will give you 60 PDUs. That 60 PDUs you have to enter. See, just to ensure that normally what is human tendency? Once you get certified, you will get relaxed. You stop getting knowledge related to project management, or you stop doing any activity related to project management. To avoid that, even after getting certified, to ensure that you are doing some activity in project management. If you do some projects, if you work in some projects, you will get some PDUs. If you do some training, it means you are helping others related to project management, you will get some PDUs. You watch some videos, you watch some sessions, you will get some PDUs. It means you are doing the knowledge acquisition, you are acquiring your knowledge. So that is how 60 hours somehow you have to spend on projects, which you will be knowing better after this end of the session, or later I will take it. First, let us concentrate on how to get the certification. Then we will see what to be done after getting the certification. And PDU stands for Professional Development Unit. PMBOK, Project Management Body of Knowledge, and PMBOK Guide is a textbook for PMP certification examination. This is a guide, basically. This is a guide. And exam eligibility requirements. Does everyone know exam eligibility requirement?
Yes, I know.
I also know.
Okay. Okay. So there are, quickly I will do a recap. Either bachelor's degree or high school diploma. If you are a graduate, you need 4,500 hours of project management experience. Okay. That is 3 years, 8 hours per day, somewhere on those grounds. And 35 hours training is mandatory. Project management training is mandatory. 35 hour contact hours. See, whatever the training you are getting now is the contact hours, not the PDUs. Normally people will confuse with PDUs and contact hours. Before PMP, whatever the number of hours you are spending towards knowledge acquisition or project management training is called contact hour. PDU is after PMP. Professional Development Unit. You are developing professionally, for which they will be awarding you some credit. That is called PDUs. So if you are a diploma holder, it's a 7,500 hours. That is equivalent to 5 years. And the examination, 200 questions will be there, 4 hours duration, multiple choice. Out of 200, 25 are considered as pre-test, dummy questions you can say, and only 175 are scored. I mean, only 175 will be valued. The rest of the 25 questions are dummy questions, but you never know what are those 25 questions. You can never know. So, and you have a grading system. You don't have any, they don't give you any percentage, 70%, 60%, 80%, they don't give. They give whether pass or fail, and they give which grade you are into, below proficient or moderately proficient, whether you are good, proficient in planning, or whether you are proficient in execution, or moderately proficient in closing, in which process group you are more proficient. So the result will be given on process group base. Planning, we are good in planning, or you are good in initiation, or you are good in execution, whether you are good in monitoring and control, that is how it will be. And there is no negative marking. And all the process, see, there are 47 processes. PMP is all about studying some basics and 47 processes and professional and social responsibility. Three things. You will study some basics, which I will be covering today, and then all the process, 47 process. That is, there are certain activities which you do. Each type of activity is a process. 47 activities and professional and social responsibility. All these 47 process, they fall either into initiation, planning, execution, monitoring and controlling, or closing. Initiation is just before the start of the project. At the start of the project, you will have some activities which you do. All these activities will fall under initiation, all this process. You have to plan your project, so planning. Once you plan, you have to execute it, that is executing. Whatever you execute, that time you have to monitor and control. You have to monitor whether you are executing as per the plan, or is it getting out of control. Is there any variation between what you plan and what the actual is? You have to monitor and control. If you find something is fishy and it is going out of control, you have to control as a project manager. That is monitoring and control. Closing. There are certain activities which I told you earlier, that during closing also you will be doing these activities. So these are the percentage of questions what you get. Under initiation, out of 200 questions, 13% come from initiation, that is 26 questions. Planning 24 is 48, execution 30 is 60, mounting and control 25 questions, that is 50 questions come from these areas, closing 16 groups. This will help out to concentrate on the process in order to clear the examination. The entire syllabus is covered, as I told, into 47 process, 5 process groups, and 10 knowledge areas. You don't worry about understanding this. You'll be knowing subsequently what is a knowledge area, what is a process group, what are the process later. And now clear quickly the definition. These things we have done on Friday. Okay. So since there are newcomers today, I'm doing a quick recap. So again, I'm requesting for the people who attended on Friday to just bear with me. So what is a project? The definition of a project. Very important for the examination. If you understand this definition, at least you can expect 2 to 3 questions in the examination. And don't think that the same question will be repeated 2-3 times. No. The context of the question will be used in order to in the examination, the context will be used. So now let us try to understand the definition of a project. A project is a temporary endeavor, they are saying. What do you mean by endeavor? Endeavor is an attempt. The English meaning of endeavor is an attempt. Project is a temporary endeavor. It means a project will always have a start date and end date, a beginning date or end date. So a project should always have a start date and end date. If there is no end date, then it's not a project. The project will take 6 months. So the date on 6th month from now is the project end date. So then only it's a project. If it is not, if there is no end date, there is no project. So when we say temporary endeavor, it doesn't mean that it is temporary in nature. The temporary nature is, says a project always comes with a start date and an end date. A start date and an expiry date or whatever you say. Why do you do a project? Why do you do a project? You undertake a project to create a unique product, service or result. A project, end product of a project is unique. Remember, outcome of a project is always unique. It's not repetitive. For the first time you do it, or you don't find such thing earlier, or it is always unique by itself. Okay. For example, you are developing Apple i6. For the first time, you are a project manager working in Apple. You have developed a new mobile model. Smartphone model, Apple i6. It's unique. First time you take it up as a project and you produce this. Okay. So it is unique. After that, this particular i6, they may manufacture 100 million phones in order to sell in the market. Then that is not a project. That is called operations. That's called operations, manufacturing, operations. That is different thing. That is not a project. So the outcome of a project is always a unique product, or sometimes it can be result also. Need not be the product every time. For example, if you take pulse polio program, project pulse polio, no, polio drops in India, government used to give polio drops for the kids. Okay. They have taken up this project called pulse polio in India for a result. It's not a product. What is the result they are looking at? Polio free India. There should not be polio in India. Polio free India is a result. So, sometimes you take up a project for result also. And remember, anything can be a project. Even if you are conducting an event, you are conducting your sister's marriage or brother's marriage, even you can take it up as a project. Nothing wrong. You should have a start date and end date. Then there is a result that your sister is getting married. That is the result. Big outcome of this project. Successfully getting married. Okay? Or you have a capability to create a service. No, you are establishing a service that you can take up as a project. For example, service is not a project. Remember, service is not a project. Capability to perform a service is a project. You are setting up the entire call center. You are providing mobile services. Setting up the entire technology. Setting up the entire call center. Everything, it can be taken up as a project. That is, capability to perform a service. You are providing mobile services to your users. So doing the entire setup can be taken up as a project. So this diagram, this definition is very important. A project is a temporary endeavor. When I say temporary endeavor, it has a start date and end date. And you undertake a project to create a unique, the word unique is very, very important. In the examination, they throw you situations where sometimes they talk about repetitive activities. You are resolving tickets in your organization, no? In your office, you are resolving tickets, support tickets. You are resetting password or some support tickets you are doing, repetitive activities. Those are not projects. But as I told on Friday, these are called projects in real-time world, but they are not really projects. We say, I am working in support project. No. As per the definition, it is not a project. Okay, a project should always produce a unique product. Unique product. As I told on the other day, if you are developing a new formula of Pepsi, new formula, new flavor in Pepsi, that is a project. You do R&D, lot of permutations and combinations, you try and you develop a new product. Okay, but once the formula is approved, you will manufacture millions of bottles of Coca-Cola, that new flavor. That is a manufacturing or operations. That is not a project. And one more thing, if someone didn't understand the concept, feel free to stop me. There is only one agenda. We are not going to the next topic without understanding. Is it all fine with you?
Yeah.
Excellent, excellent. And what is project management? In layman terms, what is project management? Managing a project. What else? You have to manage your project. How do you manage your project? By applying your knowledge, by applying your skills, by applying your